delicious hibachi shrimp, steak, and vegetables, fried rice, and you know I did not forget the yum yum sauce. Today in Kamira's Kitchen, I am showing you how to make a delicious hibachi at home. We're gonna start with making the herb garlic butter, and I'm combining mixed dried herbs with parsley and a tablespoon of fresh minced garlic and a squeeze of half of a lemon. Whenever I say butter throughout this recipe, this is what I'm talking about. It's gonna make your hibachi extra special and flavorful. I'm gonna start with doing the fried rice. I'm throwing in half a diced onion with a tablespoon of butter. I'm putting in some fresh ginger for a little bit of a zing, and I'm gonna stir fry for about 30 seconds. Next, I'm putting in frozen vegetables, and I'm gonna cook those until they're unthawed, and I'm gonna start working on the fried egg. I just love fried egg in my fried rice. I can't do without it, so I'm gonna scramble one egg in my rice. I'm going to cook it until it's done, and I'm adding a little bit of salt. Once it's scrambled, I'm gonna mix it in with my veggies so that when it's time to add my rice, this is all well combined. I am using day-old rice, and it's 2 cups of rice that I cooked. So this is about 4 cups of cooked rice total. I'm gonna stir everything together, and then I'm gonna add my soy sauce. Now guys, add soy sauce to your taste. Soy sauce is salty, so just be mindful of how much you put in. So I'm really eyeballing it here. After I mixed it together, I decided that it needed a little bit more, so I went in with some extra and some sesame oil. Ah, so key to that roasted flavor. Don't leave out the sesame oil and some green onions. Give me a like if this fried rice looks amazing. Guess what? It is done, and this only took about 5 minutes. Next, we're going to be moving on to our hibachi vegetables. I'm throwing in some rough diced red onion, zucchini, and squash that are fresh from my garden. I just love them this time of year. And I'm going to give those a quick stir around. I am putting in a little bit of fresh ginger, about 2 teaspoons of fresh ginger. And I'm also going to put in a tablespoon of that garlic butter. I allow this to cook for about 5 minutes. To be honest, I like a little crunch on my veggies, so I don't really let it go too long. And of course, I'm putting in soy sauce to taste, and I'm stirring everything around. You, of course, can add salt to however much you like, but these veggies are light and delicious. They're not loaded down or oily. I just love this recipe, and these are ready to go with our hibachi meal. Up next is my favorite part of the hibachi, which is some hibachi steak. I'm using tip sirloin that I've cut into cubes, and I really like my steak to be kind of medium well, so I'm not letting mine go too long. I really like a juiced steak, so you cook your steak to your desired level of doneness. For this tip sirloin, I really only cooked it for about 4 minutes until it got a nice little char on the outside, but was still a little bit pink and juicy on the inside. Teriyaki sauce is the key to this steak. Do not leave it out, guys. Don't just do soy sauce. The teriyaki sauce is so special on this. And of course, I'm gonna use a little bit of sesame oil just to give it that roasted flavor. And this is done and delicious. The last part of our amazing hibachi is the shrimp. We all know shrimp do not take very long to cook, so this took only about 2 to 3 minutes. My shrimp are kind of small, so you don't want to overdo it. I'm of course putting in that garlic butter, and I'm also going to be using teriyaki sauce for our shrimp as well. Don't skip, okay? It's a must for this. And after about 2 to 3 minutes, my shrimp is done and it is ready to go. And guess what? We're gonna eat a delicious hibachi at home. The recipe for the yum yum sauce is in the description box, because you know we can't have hibachi without that. Guys, I really hope you love this recipe. This was daggone delicious. Follow me for new recipes every week. And goodbye. I'm so glad you joined me.